knows what evil lurks in the heart of game. The Shadow Knows.
Hi, I'm The Shadow Knows, and I'm back with another Let's Compare video. Tonight I compare the game Fighting Soccer on the Commodore 64, the Amstrad CPC, the Sinclair Spectrum, the Atari ST, and the Commodore Amiga. And this doesn't look too bad for the Commodore 64. And yeah, it loads. Not sure if it's compatible with my SpeedDOS. Then it shouldn't load too long. But it seems to be compatible in that way that it doesn't crash. But it doesn't seem to utilize the parallel cable, or does it? Okay, one player versus computer, and I'll take FX and the music. And yes, I think I'm what? Yes, it's very jerky. And this could have been sponsored by the Green Party. But the music is not too bad. How do they manage to get such a jerky game on the Commodore 64? Yeah, color scheme also doesn't help. And where's the fighting? And it's England versus Japan. Or Great Britain versus Japan. And Japan wins. So in some way, maybe this game is a little bit realistic. Ah. Okay, 1-1. 3 seconds left. I won't score again. And that's the end of the match, and I like that there's no second half because the game is awful. So on to the Amstrad. Okay, back with the Amstrad version. Joystick 1. Press return when finished. One player versus computer. Okay. Yeah, and this game was a real pain in the ass because the disk image is the only tape image I could find was uh, Hey, can't I shoot? Yeah, the tape image had extra data on side one. Which actually looked like the data needed from site 2. But it wasn't. Why doesn't he shoot? Yeah, and it loaded up to the it loaded the title screen all right. Loaded the title sequence all right. And because I usually put side A and side B on the same tape right after each other, I thought, yeah, it was the right data, and it wasn't, and it crashed, and it was a real pain shit. And that's when emulators come in handy, because yeah, when I tried it out in an emulator, it also didn't work, and that's usually either a sign of a really corrupt tape image, and yeah, I did get it running. Was it worth it? Not really. Well, it's not as bad as the Commodore 64 version. And why is there no sound at all? No, I didn't turn down the volume. Yeah, maybe it doesn't feel that bad because you don't expect that much from the Amstrad. Yeah, but that was Fighting Soccer on the Amstrad. Took me about 1.5 days to get it loading, and I played 3.5 minutes, that's a very good ratio, onto the Spectrum version. Okay, back with the Spectrum version, and this is 128K version, and I think, no, I have to press enter, and I hope it works. 128K version means that it has music. Yes, it does work. Great. And it's even faster than the other two versions. This is playable. Okay. So far, Spectrum is the clear winner. This has a decent frame rate and is a playable soccer game. Still not the greatest game, but much better than the other two 8-bit versions. No, this is not that terrible. I still find it very hard to play any combinations, but yeah, not as terrible as the other two versions. shit. Yeah, and I really like that they did a 128K version. Where you don't have to load after the title sequence, I think. It just loads 8 minutes. And that's it. And 8 minutes is quite a lot, but... yeah, you get the animated title sequence. Yeah, and I don't know if you can see it in the video, but the player run almost as fast as they can shoot the ball. Ah, shit. That's not very realistic. Yeah, so it's still a bad game. Just not as bad as on the other two 8-bit systems. I'm not getting a great 16-bit version of this game. And if it's SNK, was it the Neo Geo? Yeah, shit. And if it was the Neo Geo, I bet it was much better than this. Yeah, but the music is not bad. And you get this every time. On the Amstrad you got basically the same sequence, but in color, of course. And you only got it once, and then it continued loading. So yeah, on to the... I think it's the Atari ST version. Okay, back with the ST version. Why wait? Okay, it has a little fancier intro sequence, I think. No, it doesn't. It's even more boring. Great, I then select up. Awesome. Let me guess. It's one of those games that I think it's clever to have the first player plugged into port 1. So I play core. Oh god. And one player will be randomly controlled by the mouse, which is not very good. Let's see if he will run in the other direction. Yeah, this is definitely more playable. And it has incredibly bad speech synthesis. Yeah, but scrolling is quite good. I don't mind the graphics. Music is probably a little bit annoying. No, it's not the worst football game in the world. Yeah, and having a second player controlled by the mouse doesn't really help. But I'm not going to swap the joystick. If you have ever seen a STE or STFM or STF, then you know why I will not swap the joysticks. Yeah, works every time. Still not a great football game, but not as bad as the 8-bit. And I think it's even more playable than the Spectrum version. Yeah, that's helpful. And the music is annoying. Yeah, the AI is more A than I. Not very clever computer players. But this could actually be fun with two players in co-op against the computer. Yes. Because then your player won't steal your own ball. And he's still... yeah, still not a very good football game. And it doesn't help that the music starts from the beginning every time one team scores a goal. Yeah, but also the ball speed, ball physics, much more realistic than on the 8-bit systems. The player don't run as fast as the ball. Yeah, awesome. Mm. 8 seconds left to the Amiga version. Ah, shit. Doesn't work every time. And you can shove your throw in somewhere else. A corner? Seriously? Yeah. Okay, on to the Amiga version. Okay, finally, the Amiga version. And it does have the fancy intro, and I crank up the volume a little. Yeah, same issue as on the ST. So I have to play co-op again. And yeah, it loads. And I think the Amiga loads much more than the ST. On the same games. Loading times on the ST are quick, definitely quicker than on the Amiga. Maybe because it's yeah, it has the same crappy. Great, and I think it does look better. Yes, it does look better. But it's slower for some reason. Yeah, the sound effects are also. And nobody's cheering, yeah. That speaks for the game. Really, nobody's cheering. And it really doesn't help that the music starts all over again. Great. And it shouldn't be that hard to make a decent football game on the Amiga. I mean, the Amiga's graphics chip is made for it, for a top-down football game. No programming tricks required at all for the playfield. You also get 8 sprites per scan line, which you can multiplex. Really, making games on the Amiga is very easy. Oh, come on! I can't score a single goal? That was much easier than on the ST. Yeah. Again, not as bad as the 8-bit versions. That's expected, but sadly enough, not always the case. And it's equally annoying to swap the joysticks on the Amiga then as it is on the ST. How shall I score a goal? Yeah. The computer knows how to score a goal. 26 seconds and it's over. 26 seconds and I never have to play fighting soccer again. Yeah, sound effects are really bad. 4 seconds and it's over. Okay, end of match. And the end of this video, that was fighting soccer on Commodore 64, Amstrad, Spectrum, Atari and Amiga. Not a good game on any of those systems. The 16-bit versions are the least unplayable. Horrible Commodore 64 and Amstrad version. Spectrum version, best of the 8-bit, but don't play any of those. If you want to play a football game, there are much, much better games. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video and thanks for watching.